Okay, so we're getting close to the end. But now we're gonna go ahead and cause some damage. Now, I'm gonna do something a bit different here. The present. This is where I wanna go. So we're gonna make a save here, because what I want to do is fight this boss and do some... So we're gonna choose Nuvius. It's the same fight anyways. So we're gonna stop there. So that is the fight in the past. Now we're not choosing that. So we're gonna go actually the real thing that will stop everything. Stop Vol Terrilis in the past. Now, this will lock me into an ending. So technically, it depends on who you choose, because this is why it requires two playthroughs. You either lock yourself to stopping the War of the Sisters, or stopping the killing of your family, of your clan. This is why it takes two playthroughs to do this. Nuvius is to stop the... is to save your Winderia, I think that was called. But this is to, you know, protect the, stop the War of the Sisters. And basically, this one, we're just going to choose War of the Sisters. And everything has faded. Reality has been broken. We was warned. Dark force. Hey, look, it's the Sandman. He's a lion. Ancient pyramid. So here's something funny to note. I'm gonna go here real quick. Now, because this is just fragmented dreams, I guess it doesn't show up. Or maybe it won't show up in the past. Let me try the future. So, there's supposed to be an enemy that pops up here because technically this is all just, you know, a figment of her dreams. So I'm gonna see if it will actually show itself. It probably won't, but it doesn't hurt to try. It doesn't want to show. It is possible for it to show up in one of these towers. There's a special type of enemy that could show up. Normally it would show up, but I guess it won't. Also, if I go back here, there's nothing I can do because we already locked ourselves into it. So the thing I was looking for isn't there. Even though technically it should have shown up. But we will see it soon. The ancient pyramid. This is the final area, and this is where I'm gonna have to do my little searching for my last relic. Do I got any little nest points? I do. Say immediately taking it safe with these things is the only thing I can do. This is why I'm using plasma orbs. Crap, he's too close. Celestial sash. That's the item we need. Now we can actually super jump. Literally hold the button to go up. Yeah. Oh, that's actually better. So actually, we're gonna yeet ourselves. Actually, no, for that. Time to do a last bit of cleanup. So let's go here. I like how it refreshes my double jump. Charles may defend at 42 by 1, but raises damage. I'll take it. And this is basically showing us, like, hey, yeah, her father is an emperor of their enemies. So we need to send our daughter. We must prepare her. She must undo it. So basically, her killing her father in the past undoes her normal timeline so she does not exist as the daughter of that man. What's the fastest way? Actually, we'll teleport. And this should be the last one. The true motives. I'm gonna let kind of speed on this up, so it's just gonna be on the screen for like a couple of seconds. I tried to do all this when I recorded beforehand, but our little quick fleeing gave birth to a daughter and angered a man. As Mori would say, you are the father. Claiming she's yours when you're not even married. She took the opportunity to get knocked up on you, get your seed, and use your own offspring to get you. So right now we have 11 memories, 11 letters. I'm missing 3 downloads. Zarian, I hate that. I hate him. That's the worst. Did he not count? Huh, I'm surprised the other one didn't count. First story, let's go. So we're at 99%. Oh, I see where I missed it. We're gonna have to backtrack. I'm surprised I never removed that mark, even though I already claimed it. So I'm actually gonna have to backtrack. I wonder. Does this make? Oh yes. Oh yeah, we're doing 3 of these. Yeah, we're backtracking here one last time. Oh yeah, we're gonna hit you 3 times this round. Emperor's Empire's Crown. Yeah, we're gonna put that on. And we're now 100% here. And now we can go. We can leave the present. The present is now done. I already got 100%. And now we're going to go back to the past. And once I go through the past, we are just... we're just only cleaning up a few spots here. Oh yeah, triple orbs just make this so much faster. No, I don't want to go this way. Could have straight shot up through that previous one, but I'm still gonna have to go through one of the two sides anyways. So. says Colonel Cordova Plasma refreshes 1 watt. Okay, if you... I can see that crown being built around plasma orbs. So, I'm kind of curious to why I haven't seen it. Maybe because I haven't used Time Stop as often? Princess Dress. Well, it gives me more damage and will, but at the sacrifice of defense? Sure, let's use that. And now the past is 100%. I'm gonna go ahead and use my last. I think I have. Yes, I have elemental beads on it. So we're gonna use this last one shard. So I'm kind of shocked that I have not seen. I'm surprised I haven't seen it. I'm surprised I have not seen the enemy. It's like a shadowy enemy here with eyes that normally you can't damage them normally. They're just there. They don't bother you. But the moment you freeze time, they become active. I'm surprised I haven't seen him. So, but that's enough of that. We're gonna stop here. This is gonna be quite a long video. Next video, we're gonna be running the battle arena. And we're gonna do some cleanup there because I'm gonna have to run it at least 2 to 3 times. I'm still missing one familiar though, but I don't know where it's at. Might be in the battle arena. But stay tuned for that in the next part.